5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Keep it up. Yup.
My name is Dr. Ume Sunday. I'm a physiotherapist. I also run a fitness center. One might want to wonder if fitness has become an industry in Nigeria. My answer to that is yes. It is an industry in Nigeria, and it's a good one indeed. And it's an industry in the sector of health. Yes, sometimes, depending on what you look as profit, fitness industry can be profitable, in quotes, not looking at finance as the only profit. Yes, as business, depending on how it's run, you can get good profit. What I mean is that if you're looking at profit in terms of cash alone, you may not want to go into fitness industry. But if you're looking beyond cash reward as profit, yes, you can be in fitness world and you make enough profit. Yes, in Nigeria, there are a lot of competition. People are trying to see how they can fit in. But what I know is that just like every other business, if you want your onions, you will thrive in your industry. There are competitions, many clubs, fitness clubs are coming up. Many hotels have their fitness centers. But what we're looking at is regulating the industry so that not all commerce are fair. It will be for people who can actually deliver what the industry is supposed to deliver to the masses.
Yes, my name is Engineer Kingsley, and as a hobby, I'm a fitness consultant. And just as you can see, this is open air gym. Fitness is a very big industry. In fact, it's one of the industries that has not yet been tapped in because of the, should I say, people have not really seen the advantages of fitness here in Nigeria. And a whole lot of people have not tapped in yet. Even the few people that are in the industry, they are not really, really qualified because of, you know, we don't really have a good base of certifications and training and retraining. So basically, it's a very big industry that is yet to be tapped in properly.
My name is Okpagu Tony Jack. Fitness industry, it may not be physical competition, but to you, you know you are actually having competitors. You actually have competitors out there and you need to keep up with them. So you need to actually increase what you're doing to make sure you're giving the people what they want. Like, it's not all about you opening the gym or getting into the fitness business, but offering people the service is one thing. And the service doesn't really mean that you need to do everything. You just need to provide some necessary things and some basic things, which is very necessary that you do, and people would have to come for it. So that's just it. There is a competition, yeah, but we don't actually face each other to compete. Everybody just focus on what you're doing and make sure you're doing it well.
Yeah, definitely there are competitions, but as Nigeria as a whole, the market is still very big. So you can see fitness as a competition basically in the big cities like Abuja, Lagos, Port Harcourt, because we have expatriate and more enlightened people, you know, in these cities. But basically, of course, there are competitions, but there is still room for so much to be done. A whole lot of people need to come into fitness, you know. Majorly, most captain of industry should input this fitness thing into their curriculum, so that because once your staffs are fit, the outcome of the manpower that you're employing will be more effective. So, of course, yeah.
So where do you see this industry in the next 5 to 10 years?
Basically, since there is no much awareness concerning the industry, we are still very, 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 you know, much behind. But a lot of people are, because of the health challenges people are having, people are, you know, getting aware. So in the next 5-10 years, I think we'll do much better in the next 5-10 years, yeah. Because, you know, when you see someone that looks healthy, slumps and die, or, you know, one or two heart disease, you know, when you're fit, you know, you've reduced your health problem by half, if not more. So a whole lot of people are, you know, getting aware, and, you know, they are coming into fitness, you know, they are coming out to train. As you can see, there are so much people, you know, coming out to work out, and it's a very good thing.
10, 16, 17, 18, 19, 10 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10.
They have to regulate it because of quacks. You understand? Anybody that, you know, knows how to lift weights will just come out and say he's a trainer or she's a trainer. And it doesn't work like that. So it has to be regulated. Every part of the world, fitness is regulated. It has to be licensed, you know, a whole lot of things for you to work perfectly well.
It's part of this.
Hey, the only one.